Hello children, welcome to Aksharda Public School Science Learning Platform for Grade 5. This is the mind map based presentation on chapter number 9 and the topic is Air and Water. Before going to discuss the topic with the help of a mind map, we shall look at the learning outcomes of this topic. At the end of this video, you will be able to list the importance of the atmosphere, label and describe the layers of the atmosphere, explain the properties of air, and to discuss the various methods adapted to purify water. So here is the mind map on the topic air and water. Let us know the importance of air and water. Air and water are the two most vital requirements for life on the earth. Living beings breathe in air to survive plants and also use air for photosynthesis and respiration. Similarly, water is one of our prime needs. Plants, animals and human beings cannot survive without water. So let us see the first branch, that is about the layers of atmosphere. Before that, we understand the term what is atmosphere. The thick layer of air that surrounds the earth is known as atmosphere. The various layers of the atmosphere are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. Troposphere is the layer closest to the earth, where all living things are found. It is also the layer where weather changes are observed. Aeroplanes and jets fly in this layer. The second layer is stratosphere. It contains about the 90% of the ozone in the atmosphere, which forms the ozone layer. Ozone absorbs harmful ultraviolet rays from the sun. The third layer is mesosphere. It is the coldest part of the atmosphere. Most meteoroids and asteroids burn up in the mesosphere due to the friction. It is the fourth layer of the atmosphere, that is thermosphere. It is hotter than the lower layers, though there is very little air. The last layer, that is exosphere. This is the outermost layer of the atmosphere. Some human-made satellites go around the earth in this layer. The second branch deals with importance of atmosphere. The atmosphere traps heat from the sun during the day and let it out slowly at night. The water cycle takes place in the atmosphere. The ozone layer of the atmosphere filters out the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. The atmosphere also protects the earth from asteroids and meteoroids. We are able to talk and communicate because of the atmosphere. Sound can travel only through another substance. In this case, air. The next branch deals with composition of air, or we say, what is air made up of? So, air is a mixture of gases. It contains of various gases and it constitutes about 78% nitrogen and 21% oxygen. The rest 1% consists of other gases such as carbon dioxide, argon and water vapor. Oxygen is needed for respiration and burning. Nitrogen, on the other hand, does not support burning. In fact, it controls burning. In the absence of nitrogen, even a small fire can become very big. Nitrogen is also used by plants to make food. Besides of these gases, air also contains water vapor and dust particles. The next branch deals with properties of air. These are the three properties. Air takes up space, air has weight, and air exerts pressure from all sides. We can prove these properties by doing the simple experiments. The next branch deals about water. Just like air, water is another vital natural resource for our survival. Plants and animals cannot live without water. Water is also needed for photosynthesis. 71% of our body is made up of water. Water has many uses. We use water for every day. For cleaning and cooking, irrigation, transport, and generating the electricity. Even water can dissolve many substances. Water is the solvent and the substances that dissolve in it are called solutes. Together, solvent and solutes, they form the solution. We call water is the universal solvent because many substances dissolve in it. The water we get mixed with various impurities such as sand, dirt and germs and mud. These are the substances are also called impurities. The impurities are of two types. One is insoluble impurities and another one is soluble impurities. Insoluble impurities are the ones that do not dissolve in water. For example, mud and pebbles. Soluble impurities are the ones that dissolve in water. For example, salt. So the next branch deals with removing insoluble impurities. Insoluble impurities can be removed by sedimentation, decantation and filtration. The mixture of mud and water is allowed to stand undisturbed for some time. You can see in this picture, children, here. After some time, the mud settles down at the bottom of the container as sediments. This process is called sedimentation. The clean water is poured into another separate container without disturbing the sediments. This process is called decantation. The next, filtration. In filtration, the mixture of water and impurities is passed into another container through a filter paper. The next branch deals with removing soluble impurities. Soluble impurities are separated by the methods of evaporation and distillation. Evaporation is the process of changing of water into water vapor. When water evaporates, it leaves all the dissolved impurities behind. This method can be used to get back the solid substances dissolved in water. Next, the method is distillation. In this method, water with soluble impurities is heated. The water evaporates on heating and the impurities are left behind in the container. The rising water vapor is moved to another container where it is cooled down to get the pure water. This process of changing an impure liquid into its vapor and then condensing the vapor to obtain pure liquid is called distillation. So, the last branch deals with purification of water. The water that we get from different sources has many impurities. It is purified in water treatment plants before it is sent to our homes. Here, these are the many processes in water purification. One is coagulation, sedimentation, filtration, disinfection, and the final is storage. Coagulation. Here, adding chemicals make particles stick to each other. Sedimentation. Solids settle down in settling tanks. Infiltration. Layers of sand, gravel, and charcoal are used to remove smaller particles. Disinfection. A small amount of chlorine is added to kill any bacteria or other germs that may be present in water. Storage. Water is stored in a closed tank or reservoir. This water is then supplied through a network of pipes to houses, factories, hospitals, and so on. I hope that the description on the mind map has helped you to enhance to understand the topic very well, children. So, here is the home play for you. Children, I request everyone to watch the video till the end to define the following terms. Atmosphere, impurities, sedimentation, decantation, filtration, evaporation, distillation, soluble impurities, insoluble impurities, and the last is solution. Watch the video till the end and write these terms in a long sheet. Thank you so much, children. We'll meet with another topic in the next video. Have a great day.